Very good morning to one and all present here. I am Dr. P. Sivashankaran, working as Associate Professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, Manakula Vinayagar Institute of Technology, Pondicherry. Today we are going to have an interesting topic on industrial automation. So these are the major contents we are going to discuss in today's agenda of meeting. Before going to the brief introduction on industrial automation concept, let us have a difference between what is Industry 3.0 and Industry 4.0. What is the major differences between these two platforms? First, let us start with Industry Revolution 3.0. In this stage, the major developments like introduction of PLC, program logic controller, robotic systems, CNC workstations, all came into existence in this period with the mass customization approach for doing various typical job operation on a conventional machinery by reducing the effort of a human worker. So Industry Revolution is the initial period for modernizing the industry, for modernizing the manufacturing industries. Next, in today's scenario, we are approaching towards Industry Revolution 4. So in Revolution 4, upcoming technological developments like Internet of Things, digital twins, these are some of the things are going to come over in future. Industry Revolution 4.0 is fully going to be like a cyber integration system, starting from the enterprise business level to the shop floor level. So with this little introduction, now we will go to the today's topic, industrial automation. So we are going to focus more on Industry Revolution 3 in today's meeting with the help of a simulation software, robotic automation process simulator. First, let us have a theoretical foundation, and then we will see the simulation application with the software demo in the meantime of the presentation. So industry automation means assemblage of computers and robots interconnected with the communication and information system to serve for the common purpose in order to enhance the productivity of a organization. That was the initial aim of a manufacturing industry in the past year. Only uplifting the productivity of the organization by reducing or simplifying the work of a human operator. But in today's scenario, there is a huge demand for automation that has shifted from productivity to improving the quality and the flexibleness of manufacturing process. So one can able to see the automation on a bi-directional way. We can able to improve the maximum profit by increasing the product output. At the same time, we can able to enhance the product quality by simplifying the work methods. So let us have a simple example. In an automobile industry, let us take an assembly, simple product assembly line. Manufacturing of pistons and engine cylinders. So now I'm going to integrate piston into the engine cylinder by equipping a human labor. So it will have an error rate of 1 to 1.5% in every batch. This is regarding the manual operation process by allowing the human labor. Even though they are highly skilled and experienced, due to some over tiredness or burden, the humans may try to do some wrong process assembly sequence. At the same time, you equip automation, it will work in a highly programmable way, by so that we can able to reduce the percentage of error from 1.5 to 0.0001 percentage. From this example, we can able to understand the need and essence of automation that highly helps the human society. Then automation takes a further step in helping the human operator in a more artificial way, similar to the human decision-making process. Let us have a confined way of definition according to the existing review of literature. So industrial automation is nothing but a self-dictation process. So without the guide of a human worker, the machines can able to work individually on its own. So automation came from the Greek word auto and matos. So together we can coin as automation. What is the purpose of using on industrial automation? So the main aim of using industrial automation to improve the high production turnover and minimizing the optimum cost of operation by using the latest technological advancement in automation field, then improving the product quality by ensuring the work safety, by minimizing the accidents inside the plant shop floor, then at last we can able to reduce the manual inspection by going for automated inspection. So these are the various objectives of industrial automation. Next, we will go for hierarchy of automation, different levels of automation. Starting from the field level, equipping automation for hardware devices, let us say a motor control system. If I want to address the health monitoring status of an electric motor, so using sensor and transducers, I can able to do the condition-based monitoring of an electric motor using automation, so that I can able to find out the possibility of wear rate due to friction across the brake shoe and the coil windings. The next level of automation can be implemented in operation control system like PLC, robotic machines, CNC, workstations. And the middle level is the supervisory computers. And at the topmost level is the admin level. There we can able to store a huge couple of data that act as a central hub for distributing the data from different platforms. Now let us go through the concept of industrial automation by a simple organizational triangle. So at the enterprise level, we can able to change the business strategy plan using automation softwares like Python programming embedded with artificial intelligence. Then next, under plant level, using database management system, we can able to store the plant related information in batches in huge numbers. Under operation maintenance monitoring, similarly process operation, so we can equip the automation either by going for programmable automation or fixed automation or flexible automation. Out of these three, any one may suit the best need. And last, energy monitoring of the control systems or hardware peripheral devices. So for each every entity, we require the sourcing of network with the help of a protocol, common networking protocol, open system interconnection model, which has a basic LAN, local area network interface. These concepts are age-old traditional concepts which are found in the beginning era of Industrial Revolution 3.0. Now let us see the various classification of automation, fixed automation. So in this type, it is not easier to add more number of the product variety into the assembly line, product assembly line. Once we fix the sequence for a job operation, it is too difficult to change it. So the type of the problem we can consider the single model assembly line. And programmable automation, in this automation, we can have little addition of product variety, but we have some constraint or limit depending on the capacity planning of the machineries. If you want to reconfigure the capacity planning of a machinery, that is going to be a big challenging task for an operator. It will take a long cycle time to reconfigure it. So it is not possible in programmable automation to maintain the level of work flexibility and more number of product varieties to be added. Maximum we can have two or three different variety of products to be manufactured in programmable automation. The third one is flexible automation. So this creates more valuable advantage as compared to the earlier two classification. So in flexible automation, we can go for multiple job functions. Instantly, we can able to create a new design, or we can make changes in the operation planning sequence of a job. Thereby, we call this kind of automation as a FMS, flexible manufacturing systems. Now we will see a simple demo on industrial automation with a simulation software. So now you are seeing the workbench of a robotic process simulator software. First of all, let us define the new workstation to be selected. Select new workstation. Then I'm going to do the collision-free mapping exercise using the robotic arm manipulator. So go to file, open the existing files. Okay, select and download the type of a robotic machine to be placed on the workstation. Now go to the option utilities. I want to do the collision free motion planner. Click that option, create a collision free map. So here these are the pseudo random numbers which are generated under each row. First of all, let me tell you the purpose of doing the collision-free mapping assessment in a robotic arm. Let us take an example of a collaborative robot, not a single robot. 1,000 or 2,500 robots are working in a common assembly line. So definitely there may be a problem, collision or accident between two robotic machines. So we want to avoid the collision occurrence between the two parallel robotic machines. So to analyze which would be the minimum and safest movement of an arm so that we can able to free the collision problem. So now let us start the exercise of a collision mapping. So the number of iteration you are going to run the experiment, let us take 5 iteration. Then subpopulation size 2 and degrees of freedom I'm going to fix as 3. Then update map. So it is going to calculate. So this collision free mapping tool will calculate the movement of a robotic arm with respect to the coordinate axis, depending on the data which is prefetched here. So in 10 different combinations, we can able to measure the movement of the robotic arm manipulator. How that is possible? So the main population size is 5, the subpopulation size is 2. So 5 into 2 combinations, totally 10 combinations, I can able to simulate. From that, I can find out the minimum safest possible movement of a robotic arm can be implemented for a final design in a real-time scenario. So now I will conclude the meeting. So the main purpose of going for automation is to improve the quality of work and also standard output we want to produce using such automated technologies. And it is known from the fact that our country has the second leading manpower, youngest workforce in the world. So from this point of view, I would like to say that automation will never spoil the human jobs. It will be a value added supplementary to the human workforce in order to reskill the talent pool of the human worker. So this is my strong statement I would like to stress upon in the closing remarks. So with this, I thank one and all for gathering here for this workshop on industrial automation. Thank you very much.